Okay, now we have 2 minutes to start. Let's see. Who do we have here? Yes, luck will definitely be needed here. Now the wind is not as cold as it was in the morning. Sun is heating up the area. I can certainly feel that. Not sure how that will affect the
first 3 seconds.
Thermals.
Try again.
20 seconds to start. So I bet on no late starts in this round. 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everyone went far upwind. So there's an interesting strategy that I see, going high speed low to the ground, possibly in boundary layer where there's less wind movement, and only in the last 10 seconds climbing sharply. So there's only one plane to the north that I can see, and there's then a bunch of planes far up the valley to the south. I guess you can see some shining spots in this direction. Still too far to zoom in meaningfully. Let's see who's now going downwind. Two planes lower than the rest. There's one further downwind, but really far out to the south. Not sure if I can even show that. Some planes close to the peak. It's good to have some horizon reference so that it's visible what the plane is doing. Just blue background and my camera shaking. It's hard to tell what's happening. But this is much better, I hope. Yes, this one is getting ready to land. Because there doesn't seem to be any good air around. One more, two more, three planes down. Okay, what's happening behind me? One just above me, overhead.
10 minutes remaining.
Two more coming as well. But then there are two guys still decently high. Far out, but also coming back. Generally this area where I'm looking at, let's see if I can find them. One is here. High still. Running back to the point. Very nice. Guys, still really high. Not sure if I can even get him. This will be again huge difference in scoring. Closer. So this is the kind of lottery we see here. It's very hard to tell in which area of the sky or which direction in the valley you want to go at the start. But once you park yourself somewhere, you're committed there isn't much chance of moving from one side of the valley to the other or something like that. And you just have to hope for the best. For every second, and nice Harrier landing. The last one. Not there where it was before, of course. I think he's now over the landing point as well, but still has some 150 meters. Actually, there are two planes. This one is closer to landing. Them. There's still people looking up. Looks like German team is still flying. I can even get him, so he's still like 300 plus meters, closer to 400 I would say. Up there, with good 3 minutes to go. Now that must be an achievement. Nothing to do but wait for him to come down, I guess. Coming down at decent speed. track him. To go, that's gonna be fast. He went in the front, which kind of makes sense. Difficulty following him. Second, still in the front. Twenty seconds. Amazing. Amazing. That's probably best flight of the show. Okay. Now what? One more like that? Let's see. Two minutes to start of what is hopefully the last flight for the seniors, if everything goes well. While we were having a preparation, there was a group of flock of seven white storks far to the north of the valley that nicely plotted out the shape of a thermal bubble, and as expected it is spread out over a few hundred meters in length with no well-defined core. It's just a slightly warmer than surrounding air. Some storks gained maybe 150 meters or so, and then they decided it's not worth it and flew back to where they came from. So this is the visual representation of how the thermals look like here. Although right now, well, it's 50 seconds to start, the wind calms down a bit. At least here, flags in the camp are still waving madly. I would say one thermal just went past me, but this one is going to be downwind pretty soon as well. With 30 seconds to go, it would be more than 100 meters behind me. That's no good.
10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Noise. Pick a random plane. Straight. Straight up on a diagonal. And let me look around, what's the situation? Shining again towards the mountains to the south. So I would say most of the planes are there. Lots of shining, nicely spread out. I have lots of guys here just following them. Ukraine, Italia, I think Croatian guys. Yep. All very far. All I can show is the mountain ridge and hope that every now and then there is a little bit of something. Because the wind is blowing like crazy now. I have 4 planes in the frame now. Pretty nice. Doesn't look as good as it was before. There's one pretty low already. Blown away. Let's see if there's anyone closer. There are a few. That will be an outlanding, hopefully without damage. Behind the tree. But somewhere there. Okay, someone's landing. I see more people looking back or running back. So it wasn't the only one that went too far downwind. competition now. People are risking everything. Two more planes getting ready to land, or at least above the landing points. And that's the third one from below, and fourth one coming from my left. So he still think he can do a circle or two, maybe, but doesn't look too good. Made it to the point. Very good.
Yes, good one. Minute 30.
Okay.
To go.
Three planes still up here. With 5 minutes to go. It's now immediately above me. I have a stork there. Okay, but stork is much, much higher than they are. So, two more planes here. Nicely done.
Yeah.
Now wind has suddenly quieted down again. That can really ruin your landing. But this guy managed nicely. Now it's blowing up again. Applause for that one. I guess, or I would say all of the people flying in this weather deserve applause. Because this is really hard work. In Slovenia we say it's not a fight, it's a butchering. And still one plane in the air doing the victory rolls. I think this is the Ukrainian pilot. Oh, okay, he's now a bit downwind, not really overhead. I can actually do a get him at an angle. Burning some energy. Decent speed on landing.
9, 8, 7,
and to the dot.
Yeah!
Very good. Congratulations. Okay. Now all that remains is to see the results.